Hey guys, I'm Wench Fairy, and welcome back to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. We are on the Ebon Hawk, getting ready to leave Manon. I went through our inventory and pulled out a lot of extraneous stuff. Although, for some reason, not the memos. I'm not sure why I didn't take those out of my inventory. Or the data pads. Or any of these quest items. Oh, because I couldn't. Never mind. Haha. All right. I know I said last episode to comment if you cared what planet we went to next. At this current point in time, there are no comments saying either way, so I have picked where we're going to next. We're going to Tatooine. Why? Because I feel like it. There's Manon. Bye, Manon. I can't say I'm going to miss you. That would be a lie. Please, no space battle. Oh God. I think I'd almost rather have a space battle than another nightmare slash vision. I bet we share this one with a Bastila too. Can't even have my own nightmares. So the star map is in amongst a bunch of messed up statues. Fabulous. I mean, this is an arid desert planet. We can just say, hey, where are all the messed up statues? I cannot remember. We probably don't land in Mos Eisley because this is thousands of years before A New Hope. Okay. Yeah.
Another vision. The Force is guiding us, helping us retrace the steps of Malak and his old master, leading us ever closer to the Star Forge.
I mean, theoretically.
Tatooine is known for little but blowing sand. I find it surprising that there would be a star map somewhere in its desolate wastes.
I mean, there were statues and stuff there. Maybe it wasn't always a desert.
Perhaps, though that would have been tens of thousands of years in the past. Now there's nothing but the howling emptiness of the Dune Sea. The star map would likely have to be within some kind of shelter to protect it against dust and sandstorms. I suspect.
I mean, not necessarily.
And caverns hidden in the sand.
The one we just found was on the bottom of the ocean.
The creatures of this world probably use them as their lairs. No doubt things will become more clear once we discover the star map's location.
All right, who's coming with us this time? We just kind of made nicey nice with Karth, so I feel like I need to bring him with us. But other than that, I'm not really sure. Huh. The Karth Juhani party has failed us before. Spring mission. Why not, right?
Welcome to Anchorhead, potential customer. Zerka Corporation stands ready to serve.
I'm a Jedi.
Formalities, of course. First, your ship is not on our list of planned arrivals for today. There is a docking fee of 100 credits because of this.
Let's give them the 100 credits. Yeah, what do I get for my 100 credits?
The immediate benefit is access to these very docking facilities. This is the only port in Anchorhead. Once you've paid, we will offer trade services as well. We're not unreasonable, we just want to cover expenses.
I don't need to pay the fee.
You know, I don't think you need to pay the fee. We'll let it go this time.
Well, that was easy. Sure wish I had special mind-affecting force powers.
This will cover any future landings as well. It's like a registration, so we can serve you better when you return. Now, as a customs officer...
That's why we took Force Persuade.
Is this visit business or pleasure?
I mean, a little bit of both. Tell me about Tatooine, Circa Corporation dude.
There isn't much to tell. It's a very old planet, well past its prime. Zirka Corporation is the only company with any interest in it. It's not a very pretty world, but there is opportunity here if you know where to look.
Okay, so where do we look?
It depends on what level of risk you want to take. You could ask at the Zirka office if any bounties need collecting. That's in Central Anchorage.
Force Persuade is still my favorite thing ever.
While you're at the office, ask for a hunting license so you can sell trophies to Faza in his lodge, just north of them.
Oh,
I suppose
okay.
You could also take up swoop racing.
No.
Talk to the hut at the registration office.
Pretty much.
By the track.
No. I don't.
That's
swoop race.
West
I swoop race because I had to, not because I wanted
to.
I can't
say I know which of these jobs is the most dangerous. I stay away from all of them.
Let's ask for some background
there
on Tatooine.
Isn't much to tell. It's a very old planet, well past its prime. Zirka Corporation is the only company with any interest in it. It's not a very pretty world, but there is opportunity here if you know where to look.
Oh, I did this already. No, I didn't do that already. I was very afraid we're gonna have to listen to the whole thing all over again. Tell me about your company's operations here.
I can't really get into that. It hasn't been a very smooth operation. I shouldn't get into it.
I mean, I think you want to tell me more about it, though.
I can tell you more, I guess. It's not a big secret or anything. Just not good for business. You see, Zirka Corporation stake their claim to this planet based on some very promising geological surveys. Unfortunately, that information was incorrect, and possibly even an attempt at sabotage by a rival company.
Good. So they set up shop on a barren planet.
Not totally barren. There were a few good years of mining, and limited operations are still in place.
But
the ore is flawed. It has peculiar properties. They've had to look at other forms of business.
What do you mean when you say it's peculiar?
Zirka Corporation has really tried to hide this, but it just seems that Tatooine metal is unfit for effective manufacturing. I would imagine that this outpost will eventually be abandoned. Nobody is making any money here. Of course, this rock may have been settled a few times, so look for some other company to get stuck with it.
What other forms of business are being looked at here, if the metal doesn't
pursuits
work
that,
out?
Pursuits appeal to the casual traveler. There are some fearsome native species that provide exciting hunting. There are also lengthy barren wastes that serve as fine swoop tracks. Attracting business has been slow, however.
What do we know about the history of this planet,
very
I guess?
Little. There are hints that it might once have been a lush world. But I can't picture
See?
It as anything.
Wish Bastel was here. Let's
Native
say I told you
sentient
so.
Sentient species have no records going back that far. That was hundreds of years ago, maybe thousands. Of course, the native species are not very willing to tell anyone anything. They're barely more than animals.
What?
The sand people. They're vicious and attack outsiders on sight. More animal than anything, really. Maybe they know the history of Tatooine. Maybe they don't. Impossible to tell. They won't cooperate.
Oh. I take it you've had trouble with them,
Not
then.
Personally, but they've given Zirka Corporation a rough time. It's hard enough mining this rock without suffering random attacks. I think the company has even put a bounty on them. But I'm sure not going to try for it.
Nah. Any enemy of the Zirka Corporation is a friend of mine. Are there any other sentient races?
The Jawas are scavengers, and a bit primitive. Hard to understand. They have an affinity for droids.
Oh.
Some of our scientists believe that they may not be native to the planet. But how they got here...
Maybe I should be bringing T3M4.
As I said, they're hard to understand. They usually end up slaves to the Sand People. They aren't fighters. Good traders, though.
Oh, that's good. Let's go back to my other questions. I'm looking for very specific things. Who should I ask? I mean, I guess.
That's not much information. Could you tell me more?
Not really. Okay, antiques and artifacts.
You a digger? I've heard of ruins being found now and then, but they've always been stripped by Sand People soon after. You're not going to get anywhere with them. I guess you could ask around, but I doubt you'll learn anything different. You could always ask a Jawa. It's hard to tell what they know.
I need to get going.
As you wish. If you need anything...
He's already told us where a bunch of paying work is. Alright, we need to level up our friends here. Auto level from 8 to 12. Auto level from 11 to 12. Still pretty outstanding. If I do say so myself. Oh.
What?
So, here we are on Tatooine. Oh, a footlocker. That's nice of them. Leaving shit just hanging around. Anything else over here I can have? Oh, there's another footlocker. Aw, yeah. So, we're here, tracked down the star map. I mean, surprise, surprise, it's kind of our ongoing... Yeah, there's only one way out. Our, like, ongoing event thing. Is that a... Okay. That's a vendor, but I think all three of these people are going to want to talk to us. I'm walking up to this guy first. Jor-ul Korax. Excellent, thank you. Giska? Excuse me, did you say Giska? Yeah, I definitely did not order Creative Giska. Yeah, no. I don't know what Giska is, or I don't want it. Oh, for Pete's sakes! Really? Oh, okay. What did they just put on my ship? The disorganized port authorities on Tatooine appear to have shipped a delivery of Giska to the Ebonhawk's hold. There's been given back. Some of them escaped. Okay. Let's get back on the ship. What are Giska? It sounds like there are things that are alive. That's a Giska. Can I pick it up? No. Can I pet it? Oh. They're friendly. Peekaboo. We're playing peekaboo with the Giska. Okay, so it likes to be pet. Let's leave it alone for now. Are there lots of them? Are they everywhere? Mission?
Hey there.
Do you know anything about these Giska?
Are you sure you want to ask me about that?
I mean, I guess not. Oh god, they are everywhere, huh? Candorous?
Yeah, what do you want?
Giska.
So deal with it. Why are you asking me about it?
I just wanted to know what you thought about it. People are so hostile. T3M4. Can you make a programming spike? No, apparently not. Okay. What do you think about these Giska? You know anything about dealing with Giska? I know nothing of what you speak.
How may I be of assistance to you, Padawan?
Do you know what to do with these creatures?
I do not know how to help you with that. I am sorry.
Why do the people on my team suck so much? I'm just looking for some advice. No one gives me any advice. I'm just going to murder the little creatures.
Yes, what's on your mind?
Giska.
I'm not really sure, but you can figure it out on your own, can't you?
How can I help?
Giska?
I wish I could help you with that.
Guess what, peeps? We're going to do this. We're going to do this. We're going to do this. I guess I should have looked in the hold. Oh, I murdered. I look so sad there. Before I murder anymore. This is the cargo hold. Whoop. What happens if I kill another one? I'm just gonna... So this is a thing that's happening. What am I supposed to be doing here? Keep them out of my ship's engine, I guess. I mean, every time I kill one, another one shows up. Kill it. Yeah, every time I kill one, another one shows up. You know what? Fine. The Gizka live here now. At least until I figure out what to do about it. I understand why no one wants to help me. Yeah. We'll stick with this party for the moment. I don't know why no one wants to help me. Let's talk to this. Hey. Make Tunan juice and save your credits. Huh. This is that creature that was on Terrace. Not the same person, but the same race. Alright. Oh, yep. Usani's brand. Jammo, Hogross, Carbine, Mandalorian, Heavy Repeater. Bothan Sensory Vibe. Ooh! Oh, look at all the things! Bantha fodder and Gizka poison. I could... I get the feeling I'm gonna need that. I'm not sure I'm gonna buy that yet. I do want... That was worth nothing. Keep the hyper ones. The mines can go. Those. For now. Docking bay mechanic.
Business is up a little, so leave me to my work.
I mean, okay. Guess we'll just go out to Anchorhead for now. Apparently I can poison all the Gizka. I'm not sure if I want to do that. Ringing their necks individually is one thing. Poisoning them to death is another thing altogether. Is it cute? Does it have a cute face? Kind of, yeah. Kind of, yeah. Oh, there's a person with a name. Sharina Fizark.
Please, will you help me? I have nothing. Nothing left.
What happened?
I'll try not to take up too much of your time. I realize that everyone is out for themselves on Tatooine.
I mean, that's pretty much true.
My husband is a hunter, killed out on the dunes. This raid plate is all I have left. Please, will you buy it?
I don't know what that is.
I just can't sell it to Faza without a license. Please, I'm worried about having it. They're so rare.
What is a raid plate and where did you get it?
It's the bone plate from the head of the desert raid. My husband was so proud when he found it. He had just started hunting. He said he felt sure the next hunt would bring in more, so we waited to sell this one. Then he never came back.
Oh. Let's talk about what to do with this plate.
Will you buy it? I can't sell it myself. They're worth more than 500 credits.
Are they? I can buy it from you.
You will? Oh, thank you so much. Please, I know it's worth at least 500 credits.
Here, have your 500 credits.
Thank you. I hope it is enough. You've been...
I may have just gotten scammed, but...
My children will too.
I see we're still the good guys here. Sometimes I think we forget that.
Wow. Sometimes helping people feels pretty good,
excuse
you know?
Me, Karth?
For whatever it means, may the Force be with you. You saved us.
I'm making fucking light side points for that, aren't I? Karth, we need to talk about your attitude towards our adventure here. I am a nice person. Sometimes I do things that you might not think are nice, but I am a nice person.
Anything you want? I don't have a lot of time for talk, so please, make it quick.
Can I ask you some questions?
I always have time for a pretty face. Any face, really.
Nope.
What do you need?
You can't even see half my face. Describe your job and who you work for.
I repair the sandcrawlers when they return from the mines. They get pretty banged up, even without the attacks.
Attacks from sand people, I assume?
Sand people attack them pretty regularly. Circuit Corporation is getting pretty sick of it, I hear. They've offered bounties on sand people for a while now. But few hunters take them up on it. Too dangerous.
I mean, that's kind of fair. When do they head out?
Oh, the big crawlers head out at dawn. That's so they avoid the bigger predators. The raid, I mean. Doesn't help avoid the sand people, though. They attack pretty
regularly. Bye, mission.
No matter what Circuit Corporation tries.
What can you tell me about Tatooine and Anchorhead?
Well, it's a hole in the galaxy as far as I'm concerned. I doubt this outpost will last much longer. But that's happened before and will happen again. Anchorhead has been resettled a few times now.
Do you know why the other settlements failed? I mean, probably not.
Well, Tatooine fools people. It looks like it might have a good supply of resources, but it doesn't. Before a company learns this, they've already set up communities to support operations they now can't afford. Company pulls out, cities dry up, and after a few years, someone that doesn't know why it failed tries again.
Oh, geez. So Circuit Corporation isn't doing well here.
I guess it looked like a promising mining planet, but the metal, I tell you, it just isn't right. I've been a mechanic my whole life, and I've never seen anything corrode as fast as Tatooine metal. It's why whoever was here before left, and why Zerka will leave, and why whoever comes next will leave.
All right, thanks.
All right, then. Back to work, I guess.
What else we got happening? What's this? Nothing. Oh, don't trap me. Don't trap me. Oh, for Pete's sake.
Yeah?
There we go. Oh, hey, a Jawa. You have names?
Takum Juzdach Miki Grabbermogo.
You have a name?
Those Jawas. I don't understand a thing they say.
But if I had a droid with me. You come, you go, we scavenge. You come back, you go, we scavenge. Oh, I can speak Jawa! One of my many skills is speaking Jawa. I don't care about registering for swoop bikes. Oh shit.
Lord Malak was most displeased when he learned.
Oh, for Pete's sake, we're gonna fight in the street here.
He has promised a great reward.
And I haven't saved in a while.
You.
The what's it called? I now have a new headband. Oh, I died already. Okay, I need Bastila. Or Juhani. This is gonna go poorly. Mission's probably dead now. Okay, we got jumped and I was not prepared.
Ready?
Mission's down? No, they just switched me anyway. Give her that. How about two of them? Me one of. Okay. Mission's down. I'm just gonna let them kill me. There's no way Karth can take on three Dark Jedi all by himself. That's fine. 9 hours, 7 minutes. That's where we are. Okay. Okay. So actually what I'm gonna do... This is not a great party. I'm going to swap out Mission and Bastila. No. Mission, Juhani. Let's try this. Except I'm not going to let Juhani auto level. I realized that was pretty much the same. I want her to take the next step of cure. She can't. Character level 12. Well, butts. What do you recommend she take? Force Whirlwind? Okay. Press the wrong button. Except, I might as well have auto-leveled her up. Oh, she's gonna be level 12 here. Attributes, recommended. Skills, recommended. Feats. She automatically gets those. That's fine. Powers. What do they recommend? Heal. Excellent. That's what I was going to take anyway.
I'm here.
Let's go back out. And before we go around that corner by the swoop registration, we will turn on our energy shields and the like. I'll come back and deal with that lady in a bit. I'd rather go and deal with this. Okay, it's around this corner, so I can talk to the Jawas if I want to. I'm gonna stop right here. I'm gonna use a shield for myself, a shield for you.
Yeah?
Oh, you don't have an energy shield?
What?
Okay, well, just remember that I actually do like you, Mission. Sorry.
Lord.
And we'll just... this. Wow. And I want to hit this guy in front of me with a shock. I need a med pack. I need another med pack.
Take that. Take that.
I'm gonna back away. Stop. I'll take two of these. Oh, for Pete's sake, really?
Your wish?
Yeah, stasis, Juhani. Do it again. Okay. I didn't get a chance to use those advanced med packs, so... Mission can.
Your wish.
Whoa, I'm spinning now! This is exciting. Get him, Giovanni. When do I get critical strike lightsaber? I'm in the middle of a critical strike. I just want to attack normal for now. Mission's gonna die. Oh, she got lots of attacks queued up first. Okay.
What is it?
Yeah! Giovanni, you the best!
Yeah?
What is it?
Giovanni, can you, yeah. Mara's a little bit owie. I have to wait for her force powers to come back a bit. Let's loot the people while we do. Sith energy shield. Oh, I should give one of those to, what's her name? Mission. Ooh, more dueling shields. Oh, I used up my shield
what
as well.
It?
Yeah?
I'm here.
What did we just get? I would like this energy shield. Sith assassin pistol. Or Sith are using guns? Weird. Mission, you can have a Connie dueling shield. 1 to 8 and 23. This is 3 to 6. It's got a better spread. Like, it's smaller, but it's better. Dark Jedi Knight Robe. Oh. It's no better.
Yeah?
I'm here.
Your wish?
Heal!
Yeah?
What?
I'm gonna save. And then... Yeah.
If the Republic cared at all, it would laser the desert from orbit. Let's see the sand people hide on a sheet of glass.
Okay, well, the Republic cares, but not enough to commit genocide, so thanks for coming out.
Yeah?
What?
I wish your force powers would come back faster. That's what I wish. This doesn't go anywhere.
What is it? What? What is it?
What?
I'm here.
Is there, like, no... bar or anything on this planet? Oh, have we walked past a bunch of... We walked past the Zerka office, the hunting lodge. Oh, I'm supposed to get a... Oh, there's the cantina. Excellent. I'm supposed to get a license from the hunting lodge. Let's worry about that in a bit. Chawa! We trade in Savage and People Buy. Not so good now. I mean, that makes sense. There are many of us, but not where you can see. Okay, that also makes sense. That's another one of them big creatures. Let's go into the cantina. Actually,
what
first, heal us. Thank
what?
You. I'm almost back at full health. Let's go in here and see what happens. All right, so here we are in the cantina. There's all sorts of people in here. Zerka officers, a Jawa. Let's talk to everybody. Nobody in that corner. Nobody in that corner. Let's start with Ithorian Patron. Apparently Jawas don't be. Oh.
Yes?
What?
There we go. I'm pretty much back to full now. Let's talk to this. No? Cannot talk to the man sitting down. Let's talk to Junix Nard.
Huh? Who are you then? Only new people that come to Junix Nard's Cantina are long-time losers and bounty hunters. I don't have to tell you why the two don't mix well. Please keep any blaster fire to a minimum.
Do you have anything for sale?
Zerka Corporation only worries about keeping their own stores full. I don't have much on hand.
Oh, but he does have some. Let's buy this and this. Oh, he has infinite amount of those, okay. Security Spike, Krath Bloodblade... Bothan Quick Draw, Mandalorian Blaster, Gizka Poison again, Hair Trigger, which we don't need, Pazza Cards, which we're not into, Advanced stealth unit. I don't think I need that. But let's find out. What do I have on my head? Sorry, not on my head. Sound dampening stealth. Oh, stealth plus two. Oh, yeah.
You again.
I want to buy that. And then I can sell the one I have. And
you again. Zerk.
We'll be good. Joe, sell this. I should have brought some of my extra stuff to sell. Stealth only matters for me, the player character, so. Zerka officers.
Something you want, oh. Spacer. Go talk to the office if you want to complain about conditions here. I don't want to hear it. Seems like every other person I meet is complaining about something. Well, it's not going to get better, so leave me alone.
All right then. I just have some questions.
Trouble? Why would I want to make trouble with you? This planet has more than enough as it is.
I'm looking for something. Who knows this planet best? Oh, that's
nobody
good.
We've brought, that's for sure. Our expert said this rock was supposed to have mining potential to last for years. Nothing but garbage ore, good for nothing. You ever try to sell someone garbage? My name's Mud in three systems now.
I have to leave.
Oh, good. I have a lack of business to attend to.
Okay, don't talk to the circuit people because they know nothing. Jawa server. Why would you bother we of Jawa under Isis? Yours do not care for ours. Do you miss that we are taken? No. Are some of your people missing? Is your leader? Stands on the walls and hold out the sand. Okay. So on the way out to the Dune Sea, there might be someone who wants to talk to us.
Well, now, what can Gandalf do for you? It's been a while since
if you're a Pazak player, nothing.
Usually it's some kid wondering what my old racing days were like.
Oh.
I was back on Taris.
No, he's a swoop racer. I just wanted to ask a few questions.
I'm not sure what I have that you would be interested in. I'm just an old swoop jock that doesn't have the head for it anymore.
I'm looking for something. Who knows this planet best?
Ask me again in a few years and it'll be me. I'm probably not going back out on the circuit. There is one. But for now, I don't know any more than the next guy. Well, you should try the locals. Jowers, maybe. Funny little guy.
All right, I have to leave.
Keep safe. Yep. Seems like tough times are coming.
That guy's crazy. Everybody seems to be pointing us towards the Jawas so far.
Well, fresh face for the game. I wonder, would you care to play? My name is Furko Nellis. My vice is Pazak.
Is that somebody famous? Can I ask you some questions?
I'm sure you do, but I won't have answers. I leave other people to their business, and they leave me to mine. Really, you'll have to seek information elsewhere. But if you want some recreation, I've cards ready to play.
Jason Marsden? Something like that. You must have an opinion about what happened on Terrace. You guys talk while I try and figure this out.
An opinion would draw attention to myself.
Jason Marsden. I think Jason Marsden. Because it's not James Marsden or James Marsters. They are Cyclops from X-Men and Spike from Buffy. Although I can never remember which one's which.
All right.
This is Jason
but
Marsden.
Remember that there isn't much fun on Tatooine that isn't life-threatening. Come back if you like a game.
Can't talk to the Bith. Is this a different Jawa server? Better here than with people of sand. Okay, so they have a better life being slaves.
Your wish?
And yeah. Servers than they do as being
what?
Slaves to the sand people. It's good to know. Good to know. All right. No one else here to talk to. So let's head back out. Just occurred to me. Did we get an energy shield that I didn't give to? No. Okay.
I'm here.
When we got into the cantina, I had to take a quick break to go fold some laundry. So it just took me a minute to remember what was happening. Let's go back and see if we see how much the hunting license costs. And then we'll see if 100 credits was worth it. Sorry, 500 credits is worth buying that plate thing off of that lady over here. That's not it. Trying to make a big circle so she doesn't stop me. I mean, last time I walked up to her, so I don't think she was going to stop me, but you never know. Oh goodness, there are lots of people and lots of daylight in here. This is quite nice. Okay, who's the boss? This Ithorian. I mean, I'm not really a hunter, but what do you do in here for reals? All right. I've got some questions about hunting. Okay, at the circa office, get a license. That's fine. Now, why do I need a license? Oh, no one gets out of the city with that one. Oh, okay, so I definitely need a license. Cool. Sounds good. What is there to hunt on Tatooine? Okay. This is the plate that he says he pays well for. I have not heard about the Great Dragon. Okay. They're rare dragons, son. What's so special about Komad's father? Oh. Okay, where do I find him? He's right over there. Fabulous. Let's go back to my first questions. Do you have anything for sale or trade? Oh. Hunting license. Anything out of the ordinary happening? Do you know about anything more local? Yeah, the Circa Corporation complaining about sand people. I have to go. But I guess we'll go to the Circa Corporation, buy our hunting license for 200 credits. I don't know where that is. Right next door. I'm facing it even. Nope. It'll be this. Circa office. Can I have a hunting license, please? And thank you.
Oh, jeez.
Okay. What's going on here?
Okay.
I mean, alright then. Hello?
Can I help you? These are the offices of the Circa Corporation. I trust you have business with the company? If this is about employment, I'm afraid all regular mining positions are full. And before you ask, we are also no longer selling hunting licenses.
Why not?
As I said, we are no longer selling them. There are too many people cavorting about outside the walls as it is.
There have been a lot of people leaving the city?
With the downturn in mining, people want any chance at credits they can get. Most wouldn't survive a day, let alone qualify as hunters. The last license issued before the ban was given to a woman named Marlena Venn. She'll do fine. She had a mean streak a parsec wide. She also paid double. Exceptions like this are rare, unless it suits the company to offer them.
Why do I need a license?
We use them to ensure that only people judged fit by Circa Corporation are allowed outside the city.
So you own this whole planet?
We don't allow casual exploration because of legal concerns. Circa Corporation takes no responsibility for loss of life on
the dunes. So let people out.
It's just so we can keep track of people. No one leaves the city without a Zerka hunting license.
There's no other way to get a license?
Well, normally we charge 200 credits, but I could make an exception if you agreed to perform a task for us. It's similar to hunting. The sand people are becoming a problem. They destroy our sand crawlers and kill our miners. One particular tribe is the worst.
I mean, I kind of don't want to kill them.
Decided to wage war against us. I would like their attacks terminated. Bring me their gaffy sticks as proof. If you agree to do this, I'll give you a hunting license now and pay a bounty for each stick later. I'll give a bonus for the chieftains.
Why the gaffy sticks and why not their heads? Like, I could just get gaffy sticks.
Which would you rather have dumped on your office floor? Besides, they're ceremonial weapons, unique to each warrior. It's just as good.
I mean, I will do this for
Excellent.
You.
Now, just so we understand each other, this is an enforceable contract. Zerka Corporation takes this very seriously. Here's your license, and a few directions. We believe one of their enclaves is in the far south of the Dune Sea.
All right,
then. You might try following one of our sand crawlers. They're regularly attacked. I wouldn't mind you escorting them.
Let's go back to my first questions. Anything out of the ordinary happening? Why not?
I assume that by out of the ordinary, you're referring to the destruction of Terrace? That is all anyone is talking about. I'm afraid Zerka Corporation is not offering any comment on those events. We wouldn't wish to anger the participants.
I see. No desire to mistakenly associate with the losing side, huh?
Zerka Corporation policy is not subject to your approval. It is a sound business model. Save us your commentary.
No, about anything more local?
Events, I suggest you go to the Swoop Track, one of the few leisure industries on Tatooine. There was also a Jawa here earlier, saying something about needing help. I think he's out by the city gates. I can't be more specific about what he wanted. Our droid translators had difficulty with the message.
All right, I gotta go. Goodbye.
Zerka Corporation welcomes your future inquiries.
Let's look at that journal entry we just got about sand people. So now I have a license. I'm just gonna go out there. Like, what do you have available for purchase? Hacha! Okay. More battle armor. Powered battle armor, huh? I bet you that'd be good for Candorous. I bet you it's also 2,000 credits. A holdout blaster. Motion detection goggles. Some stealth units. A mesh underlay, which we don't need. Anything I can sell? Probably not. This, actually. I'm keeping everything else. Oh, wait. Bounties? Oh. I have to go then. I don't want to talk to you. I also don't want to talk to this lady. She gave me the license. Now I'm just going to go. Bye. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Is this about Zerka Corporation wanting to kill that tribe of sand people? I mean, I hadn't planned on even going near them, to be perfectly honest with you. They gave me a license, I'm just gonna go. I mean, yeah, why do you know any better? Like, if no one's allowed out of the city, how do you even know? I mean, that's definitely true. Zerka Corporation just showed up one day. Yeah, what do you suggest then? Oh, well, never mind then. I was going to say that. Yeah, where would I get a droid like that? An usual droid in the shop here on Tatooine. I mean, okay. So apparently I need to go to the droid shop. Where would I get robes to match theirs? So what he's saying is I should go disguise myself. Where is the enclave? Southwest. Okay. Yeah, I'll deal with the matters I see fit. I might not deal with it at all, dude. So, I knew that was going to happen. Apparently there's a strange droid at the droid shop. That means we have to go there. Opposite the cantina. Well, let's go talk to this lady.
Please.
Yes. Well, I know we've had this conversation before. Why do you need the money?
If I could sell it.
Let's talk about Duke's plate. I will buy it from you. I'll pay what you want.
Wow. This is how we just
for what. Yeah. Leave. Light side points gain. Oh, I leveled up. I should have a hunting license now. I have something to sell you. 500 credits sounds fine. If anything for sale. Excellent. So we made nothing off of that exchange, but we didn't end up out any money. So that's fine. I'm okay with it. Let's level myself up. Let's put some points into persuade. I guess a point into repair. Beats. I have force immunity, stun, and night sense. Oh, what does night sense do? Get down here. Is this night sense? Yes. +4 defense and is always active. Oh, nice. The other one was +2. Oh, cool. Force sensitive. Dueling. Single one-handed weapons in battle. I could take that. Improved toughness. Oh, it's a 2 damage resistance. Blaster deflection. +1 attack bonus with melee weapons. +1 attack bonus with lightsabers. +1 to all saving throws. I would like critical strike, actually. We're going to take that because when I was using Juhani, that was pretty awesome. Powers! What do you recommend? Stasis. There's also disable droid. Wound? No. Slow? Nah. Fear? Oh, I can level up shock. Yes. Shock is quite useful. Okay. So we can leave the city whenever we want now. Let's talk to some people. We can talk to this guy. Just a few questions, if that's okay. Looking for something. Who knows this planet best? No one that will return your questions. Okay, that's fair. You ever seen the same people with anything odd? Why would I ask that? Oh. Older ruins of sacks and other containers. Okay. What kind of ruins? That's where we want. Old storehouses of some kind, but you couldn't find them now. Human, the sand covers all. Okay. Walk south until you're a duck. What about the Jawas? Oh. I apparently speak Jawa, so it's fine. I have to leave. Goodbye. Oh, that's the guy. His name is Fortuna. I wonder if he's related to Bib Fortuna. Who are you and what do you do? This is the guy who helped us find the crate dragon if we want to do that. How long have you been doing this? Alright. Where is the best hunting? No, he's right, it is a trite answer. For reals? They're rare and dangerous, I assume. Uses battle droids to hunt. That seems like not hunting at all, but like assaulting something. What can you tell me about the other hunters? Yeah, we saw the Gamorreans over in the corner there. What about the hunters besides the Gamorreans? We all know the Gamorreans are dicks. Let's go back to my first questions. I have to leave. Goodbye. Thorak.
Get lost, Tenderfoot. I hunt Desert Raid. I don't babysit.
I mean, it's just as well. You probably couldn't teach me anything I don't already know.
Hoping to goad me into talking a bit? All right. What do you want?
Worked, didn't it? I'm looking for something who knows his planet best.
You'll have to ask around. Comad Fortuna is a much more experienced hunter than I am. He hunts far from Anchorhead. The local Jawas are a good source of information.
I have to leave. Goodbye. Okay, I don't want to talk to the rest of these hunters. They're kind of dickbags. So, let's just go. Is there anything else over here to talk to? This guy's name is Kudos. Let's talk to him. That's a cute name. Kudos. What do you do then? Oh, he plays Pazak. Okay, so the guy in the cantina plays for bad reasons and you play for good reasons? Oh. Well, that's nice. You just play to have fun. I'm not like that. I am a very sore loser, so I can't just play games for fun. I honestly just don't play games at all. I stopped playing board games and Magic the Gathering and that kind of thing because I'm a really sore loser, and I know that. So why put myself in that kind of situation? For reals. Alright, so this is the way we want to go. We want to head towards the gates, mostly because we want to go to that droid shop. There's apparently an unusual droid, and if anything says Mara Jared, Captain of the Ebon Hawk, it's unusual. So, I would still be a captain. Yeah, captain. I'm going to say captain. You know what? I haven't saved in a while. Just in case. Duros Miners, Tradesmen. Where is the droid shop? That door over there. The place of the droid outside. Let's go into the droid shop. I have a feeling the red droid is the unusual one. Inoperative droid. Got some turrets. HK-47. I mean, maybe. What do you have available in your shop?
Ivan Repur, Nikel Irimon, Dufedan Elva, Noi Fidan Elva, Uden Tufla Vandibu Elva, Noi Fidan Elva, Inuba Elva.
Let me ask a few questions about this droid, I guess. No, first I'm looking for a star map. Okay, what's stopping the Jawas from scavenging then? Okay, we knew that. That's fine. Oh, yeah, I don't need a translator. I understand most languages fine. Okay, so he really wants to sell me this HK-47 unit. Did the Jawas bring it to you? Let me ask about it. You don't, yeah, every function you can find, you don't really seem to know a whole lot about this droid you're trying to offload on me. Yeah, if you think it needs a memory wipe, why haven't you wiped it? Oh, weird. What functions have you tested then? What does the HK-47 mean? So this guy doesn't know much about this droid. I'm gonna go talk to it. Let's go back to my other questions. Goodbye.
Greeting. Hello to you, prospective purchaser. I am referred to as HK-47, a fully functional SciTech Corporation droid skilled in both combat and protocol functions.
Weird.
Query. Would you be so kind as to purchase this model from Yukalaka? It would serve my purposes to be removed from his ownership.
Yeah, what is SciTech Corporation? SciTech Corporation.
With the restraining bolt in place, I do not have access to my memory core. I suspect, however, by the fine quality of my manufacture, that they are a prestigious company indeed. I suspect I am of unique construction, or perhaps I was intended for a very specific customer. Mm. How I ended up here, I can hardly say.
He seems friendly enough.
It is sufficient to say that I am a fully capable translator and cultural analyst, and I am also proficient in personal combat.
Yeah, doesn't Yuka question you? This sentence doesn't make a lot of sense, so I'm going to ask it. Doesn't Yuka question you about your reluctance to reveal your functions?
Explanation. It is rare for a droid to resist an owner in this way. Doubtless the Ithorian considers my stubbornness an embellishment to add interest to a seemingly mundane protocol droid.
So why are you keeping information to yourself?
Explanation. I have been recently fitted with a restraining bolt, if you must know. With it in place, access to much of my memory core is restricted. Not to mention that the fool Ithorian might raise his asking price if he knew more, or make inquiries into my history. Neither outcome is beneficial to me.
Yeah. How do I know you'll be loyal once the restraining bolt is removed?
Assurance. I am fully autonomous, but lack resources. I will grant loyal service in exchange for proper maintenance. As well, it is rare that I am able to utilize my full array of abilities.
Hmm.
You seem likely to give me the opportunity to do so.
I mean, that's a thing. But why would you assume that?
Extrapolation. You are no farmer or diplomat. You are armed and comfortable as such. We will mesh well.
Oh. Access to memory is restricted.
Statement. Indeed. It is possible that the Athorian placed the restraining bolt on me to prevent my return to a previous owner. It is also possible that the removal of the bolt will not restore memory functions.
Without my memory, I don't know if I know the answer.
If I know the answer. Do not interpret this as a reduction of my worth, however. My capabilities are quite expansive.
Go back to my previous questions.
My functions are wasted.
You mentioned battle and protocol. Outline your functions.
It is not desirable for me to reveal core functions while still in the possession of Yukalaka, prospective purchaser. It is sufficient to say that...
Okay, he said that.
Objection.
Yeah, all right, I'll see about purchasing you.
The fool Athorian has decided I am to be an expensive purchase. He does this out of greed and not out of knowledge of my true capabilities.
Okay.
Advisement, I have observed him. He is a coward and will be responsive to aggressive bargaining.
Yeah, does he know you're talking smack about him?
Statement. I wish only to be purchased and away from ill treatment at the hands of this poorly skilled mechanic. I have no desire to be subtle. Qualification. Oh, of course I shall be quite pleasant to you should you purchase me, please.
So this HK-47 droid wants us to buy him. How much do you want for him, Yukalaka? First, how many credits do I have? 4,600 credits. Let me ask a few questions about him. Functions have you tested? I'm interested. Let's talk price. 5,000 credits? I can't pay that. I'm not interested. Hold on. Perhaps I can... I thought it was gonna kick me out of the dialogue. Perhaps I can convince you to go lower? The death of droid covered was a large one. You will lower your price. I deserve it.
You should treat your power with respect, not use the force on a whim like it is some toy.
You got a problem. You got a problem, you can leave. Yeah, I can't pay that. I'm not interested. Not interested. Goodbye. So 3,000 credits, huh? I have 4,600. How many med packs and stuff do I have? Am I okay there? One advance. Oh, you know what? Let's pay the 3,000 credits. There we go. 3,000 credits. That seems fair. I'll pay it. I wasn't lying about having the money. It definitely wasn't telling you everything. I know that. You know that. The droid knows that. Just give it to me. Thanks. Goodbye. Juhani, you need to touch your face. I'm going to use force persuade when I feel like it.
Statement. I see you have purchased me, Master. I find this a satisfactory arrangement. My restraining bolt will be deactivated when you take possession of me. Am I to accompany you now? Shall I kill something for you?
Kill something
and
for me?
Indeed. I am most eager to engage in some unadulterated violence.
Ooh, at your command, of course. We got robot Candorous on our hands. Yeah, sure. Travel with me now.
I will enter into your service now, Master. I am certain you will make adequate use of my primary functions. My gears are practically quivering with anticipation.
All right. We're going to keep Juhani for now. Sorry, mission. We're taking HK. No, out mission. HK. All right. So we now have a level 6 combat droid. So let's... Oh god, he's so dark side. Yes! I'm gonna auto-level him. Alright, so we have me. Another Jedi. And the world's tallest freaking droid. Oh my god, he's so tall. We will head back out into Anchorhead and then into the Dune Sea next time. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Wench Fairy. Please click the like button if you think HK47 is going to be a hoot. Because spoilers, he's hilarious. And click subscribe if you'd like to see more. This is Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. And we will see you next time.